your teams. The heart of Ohio. Bally Sports Great Lakes and Bally Sports Ohio. The heart of a fan.
Opening day is no ordinary day in baseball. Hope fills the air with much-needed optimism, and a new season once again beckons fans back to ballparks across America. Cleveland's baseball team embarks on its final season, being known as the Indians, with a new name on the horizon for next year. They have been a playoff team in four of the last five seasons, winning nearly 60% of their games over that stretch. Terry Francona's ninth season as manager in Cleveland begins with plenty of fresh new faces, eager to assume the leadership mantle vacated in the offseason by free agent defections and trades. The smile of Francisco Lindor may be gone, but the calm composure of Shane Bieber returns, headlining a starting rotation filled with promise. Last year, Bieber captured the Tribe's fifth Cy Young Award in the last 14 years, leading the league in strikeouts, pacing the majors with an ERA of 1.63.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out.
The season begins in Detroit against the Tigers team the Indians have dominated in recent years, winning 38 of their last 48 meetings. The world is just now emerging from a pandemic that changed life for all of us over the past year. Today marks another step towards returning to what we once called normal. The smell of fresh-cut grass and grilled hot dogs will arouse our senses, while the crack of the bat quickens our collective pulse. An arduous winter of discontent is now behind us. It's time to look ahead. It's time for baseball. Presented by Capital One. And it may not feel like baseball, but we've waited so long, it doesn't matter what the weather is like. We're going to play some hardball in the Motor City. Indians open the 2021 campaign against the Tigers at Comerica Park. Yes, we had snow on the ground in Cleveland. We still have snow on the ground in Cleveland. But luckily, things are a little drier up there in the Motor City. Welcome in, everyone. Matt Underwood alongside Rick Manning and Arch. When you look at this ball game today, the first thing you have to talk about is Shane Bieber. He's coming off a historic season last year for the Tribe. Not since the late, great Bob Feller as an Indians pitcher led the majors in wins, ERA, and strikeouts.
Well, Shane Bieber, right from the get-go, was outstanding. He was the best pitcher in all of baseball, and he proved why. He had a great curveball, the slider, the fastball, the location of everything. He really dominated the whole league. And when Shane Bieber is on his game, he is not going to, you know, be hit. He will not give up many hits. He was 8-1 last year, 1.63 ERA, 122 strikeouts in his 77 in the third innings. So he was just dominant, and hopefully he can get off to a start 5-1 in his career against the Tigers.
There's been a lot of talk and a lot of focus on what the Indians lost in the offseason. They still have Jose Ramirez, and he really is the engine that drives this lineup. He may not have some of the support that he's had in the past, but Rick, he finished second in the MVP voting last year.
Yeah, he was by far the best offensive player this team had when you had a down year by Lindor, Santana, some of the guys that are not back. The switch hitter did it from both sides of the plate. He heated up as the year went on, and when you look at his September numbers, he was unbelievable. 3.66 average. I think his last 12 hits were for extra bases. He had 17 home runs, but I think teams are going to approach him differently this year. They may end up trying to pitch around him, so other hitters may have to take care of some stuff.
All right, we're ready for the Indians and the Tigers. It's opening day in Major League Baseball. We'll be back with today's first pitch, and Andre Knott will stop by to try to warm us up as we get ready for a brutal first pitch when it'll be right around freezing temperature time. Cleveland Indians baseball is brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.